Pat Summitt won her first NCAA title at Tennessee. Tonight, in the most dominating run in the history of the women's game, she goes for number 6. Heading the list of her superstar weapons, Shamiqua Oldsclaw, National Player of the Year, and regarded by many as the best college player ever. When she welcomed the best freshman class in Tennessee history, the stage was set for greatness. The depth of their talent, quickness, and intensity has produced 38 consecutive wins by an incredible average of over 30 points a game. And tonight, a chance to make history. Leon Barmore is no stranger to success at Louisiana Tech with the 88 national title and college basketball's best winning percentage among active coaches. His team has fashioned a 31-3 record with all 5 starters in double figures and has shown the skill and quickness to put an end to Tennessee's dream. And tonight, perhaps fashion a storybook ending of their very own. City, where the scene is set for the women's NCAA basketball championship. A sellout crowd of 18,000 to watch the battle for a trophy that symbolizes the best the game has to offer. Number 4, Louisiana Tech against number 1 and undefeated Tennessee. Good evening, everybody. Mike Patrick along with Ann Myers. It's great to have you with us. Tennessee going for an unprecedented 39-0 record tonight. One of those victories earlier in the year against Louisiana Tech. How do they get number 39, the big one?
It'll be very up-tempo game, and how they create that tempo is their offensive rebounding and their defense. They will play 40 minutes of pressure defense, and it starts in the front court with the defense of the 3 Meeks. Shamiqua Holzclaw on the ball, and Tamika Catchings and Samika Randall in the secondary. Their defense will create their offense off steals, and you can see how they're scoring points in the tournament.
Louisiana Tech, of course, will come into this game as the underdog. What do they have to do to unseat number 1 Tennessee?
They know that rebounding is going to be a big key in this game, but also because of that pressure defense, they have to take care of the basketball. Lacan Swalworth has really stepped up her game, coming off a big game against North Carolina State of 18 points and 9 assists, but also in the middle, they've got to get a double-double from Elisa Burris, and she's going to be strong, hopefully, tonight for the Lady Texters.
Louisiana Tech lost to the Lady Vols by 14 to start the season, but they feel they are a different and a better team right now. Their chance to prove it is just moments away.
Reaching for the sky, reaching for the sky, higher, higher, higher.
From Dallas, Texas, number 35, Tamisha Jackson. At guard for Tennessee, a 5'10 junior from Sparta, Tennessee, number 14, Kelly Jolly. At guard for Louisiana Tech, a 5'6 junior from Silsby, Texas, number 10, Laquan Stoller. From Cleveland, Ohio, number 21, Samika Randall. At center for Louisiana Tech, a 6'3 senior from Chicago, Illinois, number 34, Alisa Burris. At center for Tennessee, a 6'3 sophomore from Woodstock, Georgia, number 34, junior from East Chicago, Indiana, number 21, Monica Maxwell. At forward for Tennessee, a 6'1 freshman from Duncanville, Texas, number 24, Tamika Catchings. At forward for Louisiana Tech, a 6' junior from Shreveport, Louisiana, number 30, Amanda Wilson. Introducing the head coaches for
Hold people all year with that defense. Here are the keys to Kansas City, how they got here. Louisiana Tech outscored North Carolina State by a whopping 19-0 on the fast break in the semifinals. That was devastating. And they've had a different leading scorer in all five tournament games. In fact, their starting lineup all averages in double figures. For Tennessee, inside they destroyed Arkansas by 40 points in the paint. And they have forced almost 25 turnovers a game and nearly 10 more than their opponents during the NCAA tournament. Louisiana Tech in their blue road uniforms, Tennessee in the home white.
These two teams met earlier in the season, the very first game for Louisiana Tech, which they got beat by Tennessee 75-61.
Immediately, Louisiana Tech gets the tip and goes for the bucket, and right off the bat, Alisa Burris gets the first two.
And this Louisiana Tech team stayed with Tennessee. As a matter of fact, they had a halftime lead.
Jolly goes baseline, double clutch and put it in.
Kelly Jolly has not done much in the tournament as far as statistics is concerned, but Pat Summitt knows she's the true leader out there.
Stallworth and Jackson work in the backcourt for Louisiana Tech. Jackson was the point guard at the start of the season. Stallworth took over. She has been sensational. Good ball movement, but the missed shot inside, and here comes Holdsclaw.
Those are the kind of shots the Lady Texans are going to have to knock down. Open shots.
Holdsclaw, who has struggled with her shot the last two games, they still come through with 29 and 23 points. She's going to find a way to get it done.
Where they made the adjustment against Arkansas is they put her down low and she just roamed the baseline.
Tennessee ball, Jolly to inbounds. Stevens, she'll force a shot up from the paint. Catchings with a left hand, she missed, and Holdsclaw gets the follow.
There's the rebounds that Liam Barmer was concerned as far as his team getting on the glass.
Jackson, a great entry pass again, and this time Burris with the score. If there is a weakness stand for Tennessee, it may be in post defense.
They have had some trouble inside. Stevens posting up, but they had a good job as far as Jeter coming in, so they've got a good 1-2 punch.
Holdsclaw in great rhythm there. She has the first four of six.
Coming into this game also, Louisiana Tech might want to make sure that they stay out of foul trouble because they don't have the bodies on the bench to go to as deep as Tennessee does.
Jackson with a miss. Here comes Randall. Tremendous rebounder as a guard. 3-on-2. She'll take it herself. Tennessee scores in bursts.
And that kind of shot just knocks it down. Early, the second possession that Louisiana Tech, they had a same easy shot like that. They missed it. They've got to knock those shots down. That's a tough shot coming down and just pulling up for a little 3-5 footer.
Using Stallworth on the wing to try to get some penetration and an entry pass, and she did a great job to get it to Burris again.
Lady Texter's going inside to Burris. As you said, the defense for Tennessee, they will start clogging things up there. Louisiana Tech continues to go inside.
Randall leans into one and she walked. Well, Pat Summitt isn't going to wait very long. Jeter is coming in off the bench because Burris so far has all 6 points for Louisiana Tech.
And Jeter coming in the last game really made a difference. But you see Stevens trying to front. There was a nice pick and roll right there. Three white jerseys could not really defend against Burris, but Jeter scored 11 points and had 6 rebounds, 5 blocks in the first meeting this season, and made a difference because she creates things in the middle as far as changing your shot.
She holds the single season record for block shots. This is Kelly Jolly. You've got to stop the ball. They finally did. Catchings penetrates from the wing and scores. The first two for Catchings.
You can see defensively, Mike, Louisiana Tech is kind of standing a little bit when they get beat. They need to spend their, and the reason being is because they don't want to pick up the fouls. They don't want to send Tennessee to the foul line early, but they need to bend their knees and play position defense.
Plus, they are not that deep. Tennessee just pushes at every opportunity. They got a 4-on-3 host call.
Last two possessions have been off the defensive boards, and they're just getting it down quickly. Transition defense. Leon Barmore knew that his team's got to get back. Right now, they're not doing it.
12-6, Tennessee. Jackson trying to penetrate, is cut off. A dangerous pass. Holzclaw with the steal, and the foul is going to be on Maxwell.
They ran the play right, but Amanda Wilson or Burris, whoever was setting that high pick, went away, so they couldn't get the pass out. But there's a nice break situation. That's where Tennessee is so tough, is when they come down the middle, and there you see Wilson over the back, or Maxwell over the back. And she's frustrated because Leanne Barmore said in practice, I want 3 to 4 people open when I've got one person with the ball and it's a dead ball. You better get open. And that time it was not an easy pass.
Catchings backs out to 19. Another offensive rebound, but they'll lose it this time. It's a 2-on-1. And Louisiana Tech fires up an air ball in a 2-on-1 situation. Jackson was wide open at the baseline.
Jackson.
Jolly for 3. If you let her stand still, she'll hit 90% of them.
Leon Barmore said in practice, you think I'm tough right now? Wait till you come out tomorrow and play Tennessee. They're going to be even tougher. And he wanted to challenge his team. He's like, you guys better get ready to play tomorrow.
You see how much more difficult the entry pass was that time with Jeter trying to front in the post. Kelly Jolly's three-pointer puts a period on the first 4.5 minutes. It's 15-6 Tennessee.
Call 1-800-THE-ROOF.
Oops.
From the streets of New York to the hills of Tennessee, there has been one constant in Shamiqua Holzclaw's life: championships. 6 consecutive titles have catapulted Holzclaw into an atmosphere reserved for very few. Just a junior, she is billed by some as the greatest ever to play the game in college. At Christ the King High School, this is what she did in the title games, and you can see she has always been a big-time player. And at Tennessee, she has 40 points in 2 championship games. She was the MVP a year ago.
And Tennessee making their 17th straight NCAA tournament win. They've had 17 tournament wins, and it all started with Shamiqua Holzclaw. They're going for number 18. They were 39-0 this year.
Jeter sets a screen for Randall. Reach in by Stallworth. And then Holzclaw is blocked.
Monica Maxwell coming out of nowhere. Big block trying to fire up her team.
Maxwell 5'9", blocking Holzclaw at 6'2". Now Holzclaw with an off-balance jumper. She looks like she's on her shooting game tonight. She has 8 of the first 17.
Burris is the only one that has scored on this Louisiana Tech game so far. Against Arkansas, it was a perimeter team that really picked things up. They've got to start hitting some outside shots.
There was an opportunity for Jackson, and she couldn't knock it down.
And even on the defensive end for Louisiana Tech, what they've got to do, Mike, is get a body on somebody. Just screen out.
Holzclaw feeling it again with a pull-up jumper. Holzclaw has 10. They've got to do something about her.
But you can't screen out when you hit shots like that. And Kelly Jolly hustling and almost coming up with a steal.
Stallworth a couple of times has gotten good penetration, but no one's been able to bail her out. This time she'll try her own shot, and the ball is out to Tennessee.
In practice, Louisiana Tech really worked on breaking the trap, breaking the press, but it's so different working against Tennessee rather than your own second team that doesn't get a lot of playing time to simulate what Tennessee has as far as their quickness.
Oh, you can't match the quickness. It's like you're practicing in slow motion and then the real speed hits. Holzclaw from outside. And the rebound goes to Burris, who really swings the elbow. She's really frustrated along with the rest of her teammates. They just can't get cranked up. Maxwell with a miss. Burris fighting for the rebound. Block inside by Jeter. That's what she does best, as Amanda Wilson had a chance for a follow shot.
The Lady Texans did a good job on the offensive boards that time, but defensively, Tennessee got back on the transition. As soon as the shot was missed, they knew they weren't getting the offensive end. And look at Jeter right there forcing the turnover.
What a tip by Jolly. Gets it out to Randall going one.
Oh!
What a play by Jackson. 3-on-1 coming back the other way. Louisiana Tech finally gets an easy bucket from Maxwell.
And they forgot to get back on defense.
Catching's back the other way. Holzclaw. She's Shamiqua Holmes-Claw has 12 points in 6 minutes and 45 seconds.
And this is what Tennessee wants. Louisiana Tech can run, but look, at they're taking the ball out of Laquan Stallworth's hands, so she cannot bring the ball up and start the offense. They're making Jackson do it.
Jackson against Jolly, 12:57 to go first half. It's been all Tennessee. Jackson will fire from three, rimmed out on her. Jeter with a save. Here comes Randall, looking for Holmes-Claw. How did she get that ball under control? And then the rebound is put up by Randall. A catch it.
Kind of assist, huh, when it's going your way. When the shots fall, when your first shot or two falls, you know that things are going to go well. On the other hand, Louisiana Tech, they got the ball inside to Burris, and now with Jeter on it, they have not been able to do it, and the outside players cannot hit their shots.
Biggest lead of the game, 15 points. Stallworth again leaning in. She'll draw the foul this time.
Bounce pass down low, Holmes-Claw. Everything's turning up roses for Tennessee. She goes for the shot. I guess it's kind of an assist, hey?
I think we can give that one to
her.
Shamiqua Randall picked up the personal. It's her first.
But what I like about that play, too, is that Catchings did not come down with the ball. She tipped it in, which these players on Tennessee with Holmes-Claw, Catchings, and Randall, they have the ability to go up and not come back down with the ball and tip things in, and that shows you their athletic ability.
Stallworth hits the first free throw. Ace Clement is in for the first time for Tennessee, and Jamie Shepman, number 33 for Louisiana Tech, makes her first appearance. Stallworth, who was sensational against North Carolina State with 9 assists and 18 points. Catches, leans in and got the bucket. Tennessee is not having to make hard shots.
That is a big time move right there, because the defense for Louisiana Tech is standing around. They're not helping each other out. Nice pick.
Stallworth got a good screen from Burris, and then they throw it away, trying to get it inside again.
Holmes-Claw.
Nice job by Clement. Oh, beautiful ball movement. Clement to Jolly, to Holmes-Claw, who has 14 points. Tennessee is conducting a clinic.
You took the words right out of my mouth.
Stallworth back the other way. And finally, a three-point shot. They needed it desperately from Monica Maxwell, who hit 4 in the semifinals. But Holmes-Claw right back the other way.
That's just it. You make a shot, you better hustle your tail down on the other end, because Tennessee, it's almost like off a steal, off a missed shot, they're kicking it down. But off a made basket, they're getting it out very quickly and just taking off like racehorses.
Check it, Catchings instead of Holmes-Claw on the break. They are obviously not afraid of Louisiana Tech's offensive rebounding, because they're breaking somebody all the time.
Size-wise, Louisiana Tech does not match up well on the boards. But again, as long as you can block out people and get a body on them, you've got to follow them around and keep checking them. Right now, Louisiana Tech just seems a little lost when the ball goes up in the air.
Catchings, a second-team All-American as a freshman, hits the second free throw. She has 7, and the Lady Volunteers are showing the nation how to run the fast break. Clement to Jolly to Holmes-Claw, Tennessee by 15. So does their superstar, Shamiqua Holmes-Claw. Look what she did against Arkansas. Only 4 points in the first 15 minutes. In the next 9, she had 5 out of 6 buckets and had 12 points. Then she cooled off. In the last 16 minutes, she only got 2 shots and scored 7 points. The whole team is like that because of that pressure defense and their ability to run, and she's off to a tremendous start tonight.
And Leon Barmore talked about that yesterday as far as not letting her score in spurts and get the ball in her hands.
Another steal on the inbounds. Clement gets the basket. Kelly Jolly took the pass away for a steal. Almost another one. Louisiana Tech fighting back. They get it into Shepman. She had it blocked by Jeter. Here they come again. Clement ahead of the pack. Holy cow, they are just killing Louisiana Tech. It's 32-13.
And doing it without the dribble. They're scoring off the pass.
This has gotten ugly early. Holmes-Claw kicks it out to Catchings for 3. Got her own rebound.
Nobody blocked her out.
Boy, Burris is really distraught.
Burris and Amanda Wilson, also their number four player down low, had a chance to get Ketchings blocked off, and she just took off to head down half court. Leanne Barmore with another timeout.
You made a great point about the ball not touching the floor when Tennessee ran it on the break. It was just as pretty as you could possibly have. Timeout on the court, 10:49 to go, first half. Ten, Danny.
Definitely very proud of the three-time Kodak All-American. She has improved her game, as we had talked about, the relationship that she has with Pat Summitt, not only facing the basket, but also with her back to the basket, but what's gotten involved, not only the rebounding, but passing the ball. She just has every asset, facet of the game that is complete.
Leading scorer, leading rebounder, number two in assists, excellent free throw shooter. Ketchings will go to the line. Tamika Ketchings already has 7 points. Here's the game summary from the national championship game. 15 of 24 for Tennessee. That's 63%. Louisiana Tech has hit only 28 from the floor. And off of Tennessee, out of bounds.
And in the last game, Tennessee beat Louisiana Tech points in the paint 34 to 18. And it's just so difficult, not only because of the size that Tennessee has advantage-wise against Louisiana Tech, but their quickness, because you think Louisiana Tech, they've got the quickness, but they're not getting the ball.
Here comes that trap on the jump. Shepman kicks it out to Jackson. A wide-open jump shot, and Jackson knocked it down.
And look at how quickly Tennessee getting the ball out.
That's what makes it great hand.
That's what makes it so difficult to be an offensive rebounding team for Tennessee Tech. You've got to hit your shots and then get back on defense. But Tennessee's getting the ball out so quickly, so they want to go to the offensive boards, and then if they miss, nobody's back on defense.
Holtzclaw has hit 8 of 11 shots and has 16 points. But what a change in this game since Jeter came in to play against Burris inside, and
she really has made a difference in the middle there. A give and go by Louisiana Tech. Amanda Wilson, who's held scoreless right now, averages almost 19 points a game, 15 in tournament play, and she has been held scoreless. Not getting very many touches.
6 turnovers for the Lady Texters. Randall with a pull-up jump.
This game being very up-tempo, but Tennessee is playing a very good half-court game also.
Good job by Jackson to push it, and she hits the jump shot. Tamisha Jackson can score in bunches as well. Holtzclaw with a good catch of the feet inside for the easy basket from Randall. Even when they get back on the first player to touch the ball, somebody else fills the lane.
We're talking about their secondary attack on their defensive end. It's the same thing on their offensive end. They're looking to pass the ball to who's ever open, and they're cutting.
And a travel, another turnover. The relentless pressure of the defense of Tennessee is just destroying the Lady Texters.
Not only the turnovers, but the steals, getting out-rebounded, and frustration with each other. Leon Barmore calling his team over and said, you cannot get upset at each other. You've got to stick together as a team.
He's called a 20 to talk about it. Get ready for the
of both of these programs. Louisiana Tech, way back in the 70s, dominated, and in the 80s. Then in the 90s, it was Tennessee. These teams have been played together against each other for a long, long time, even before the NCAAs. And both teams have said, hey, we just want to win this game. We don't care about tradition right now.
Postseason all time, Louisiana Tech is 5-1 against Tennessee. Somebody forgot to tell that to Tennessee tonight. And Burris, as she and Clement go down together, no call. Randall back the other way, just a great spin move. Randall is a tough, tough player.
And that one loss is when Tennessee beat them for the national championship. And today is the anniversary, 11 years ago, for that first championship for Tennessee.
And the first for Pat Summitt. Tonight she is going for her 6th. And she's got a 23-point lead right now.
And they're not going to care how big the lead is. They'll keep the pressure defense going for 40 minutes.
Jackson, a pull-up 3. Short. Knocked away. Saved by Tennessee. Jeter, great job just to bat it out. 2-on-1 with Holtzclaw. She'll take it herself. And missed the shot. Got it back.
You know what's so great about that play? She high jumped. She did not long jump. That's why she was able to recover and get the rebound. She looked like she was stretched out, but she was under such control coming back. She did not go out of bounds. And this is a great fake right there. The defense went for it, enabled it, but then the other side, Louisiana kept going back.
Stallworth, a great behind-the-back pass, but they can't get the layup out of it. And then Shipman misses the follow. Again, ahead, catching. Back to Clement. And she missed it. Boy, those are two big ones. And Pat Summitt slaps her hands together. She's upset. But gee whiz, Ann, you can't make them all.
Now, both plays are very pretty plays, but neither player finished it. Holzclaw earlier, and now Clement right there. But good passing, good team play by Tennessee. They are just looking down court every time.
LaShonda Stevens will come back in. Clement sits down.
And two key players for Burris and Stallworth going out of the game for Louisiana Tech. Two players we talked about being instrumental in this game.
Holzclaw will get a breather as well. Priya Gilmore, number 52, is in the ballgame for Louisiana Tech. She played quite a bit in the semifinals. She's at the top of the circle. Another loose ball, a steal for Tennessee, but Catchings was on the end line. She took it away from Maxwell.
Tennessee forced 28 turnovers against Arkansas. And Louisiana Tech turned it over 14 times against NC State. They're not taking care of the basketball.
Another steal. They took it away from Shepman. Kelly Jolly, the recipient of that one. Louisiana Tech, having played Tennessee early in the season, actually led them with 11 minutes to go in the ballgame. They have to be stunned. They thought they were a better team right now than they have been at the beginning of the year, but they're being shredded by Tennessee's offense and defense.
Tennessee got a little better, too.
Didn't they ever? Catchings already has 11. Holzclaw, the leader on the court, with 16. Burris hit her first three shots for Louisiana Tech. She is their leading scorer, but they've done a great job in shutting her down since.
That pressure defense.
Jackson around the screen with a shot clock at 5. Gilmore kept it alive, but Jolly comes out with it.
Look at how they're opening up the court, spreading the lane. The lane's going down. It's a nice pass by Jolly. They don't get the shot off, but they just spread the floor so well.
Right now, Tennessee getting a little bit sloppy with their running game.
That's a pretty nice shot by Monica Maxwell with a little underhand scoop.
42-19. Maxwell was 7. Catchings, the go-to player, and Holzclaw on the bench for a breather. Catchings now with 13.
And you think on that play right there, Mike, that Maxwell laterally would be quicker than Catchings. Catchings, at her size, 6'1", went right by Maxwell off the baseline.
Tennessee leads the nation in scoring, 88.7 points a game, but Louisiana Tech right behind at 86.6. But they are not having much fun in the running game tonight, and Gilmore is fouled as she goes for the foul.
And a few times offensively that they've been able to hit the glass, but there you see Catchings back to the basket. She posts up, she makes herself real wide, she gets her legs down, bends the knees, and then she's facing the basket. Good body control, stops before the defense is right there underneath the basket for the 2 points. Very versatile player, unlike
Gilmore at the line, hits the first one. 6'3" junior. Holzclaw's coming back in, so is Clement. Catchings will get a rest. 13 points and 4 boards in less than 15 minutes of action. Holzclaw has 16. Gilmore hits both free throws.
And Samika Randall was so cute. She said, hey, this is my first Final Four, and I want to win the championship for my first time. I don't know about 3 in a row.
Now, before she's done, they'll have a chance at 4 in a row with the talent they have, and that's the scary thing for the other people in college basketball, is what kind of a dynasty has Pat Summitt laid the foundation for?
Well, you get two situations. You'll either get the recruits that'll want to come and play, continue to play for that program, or you'll lose recruits because they'll go to other programs so they can play and try and beat the number one team.
And we've seen it happen both ways, haven't we?
That's right.
Jeter hits the free throw. 62% shooter. She has really come on during the tournament. She's played very, very well, especially defensively. She's been exceptional.
She's so good in that position at 6'3". And she can bang with big centers also.
45-21 Tennessee. 5:15 to go first half. And the defense just never stops. Harris may have walked. She did.
They are creating quick shots. They're creating hurried shots. With this kind of defense, they're trying to set some picks, set some screens. They're not able to get any back doors because the weak side defense is already on that side. There you see Burris open for a second. But look at the help. They called a travel on her, but there's three white jerseys on her.
9 turnovers for Louisiana Tech. Holtz ball with a rare miss. Off the tip, got it back. Scoop shot won't go. Jeter tried to keep it alive and knock it out of bounds, but last touch by Louisiana Tech. Randall will come back in, and LaShawn Stevens will sit down for Pat Summitt.
And you really have to admire the aggressiveness offensively of this Tennessee team. They just keep coming at you. Once the shot's up, they're going for the boards, but they always have somebody back so they don't get beat on the defense.
Louisiana Tech has not had that luxury tonight. They haven't had anybody back several times. Jolly trying to penetrate, knocked out of her hands. 4:44 to go first half. Louisiana Tech looks shell-shocked at this point.
Liam Barmore, we saw in the game against North Carolina State that he was up a little bit more emotional in that game.
Jackson ahead of the pack off the nice steal. 45-23, and the Lady Texans are going to need a lot more of that.
First 2 points off the turnover for them in a break situation.
Clement tries a real tough bounce pass, and it's picked off by Burris. Jackson walks it up. The Tennessee fans come to their feet as the lead has been narrowed to 22. Jackson got it to Burris. She's double-teamed and put it in. That's her first bucket since very early in the game. Her fourth basket from about that range. And Pat Summitt wants a 20-second timeout to talk about it. She does not want to see her team get sloppy and cool off, even though they built this big lead.
That's a lucky bounce pass right there because Burris trying to keep the defense off her shoulder. It's really not a bad pass, but I don't think it really was meant or intended to go there. But it's an opportunity that the Lady Texters and Leon Barmore's team needs to take advantage of and hope that they get some more to get back into this game.
4:06 to go first half. It has been all Tennessee. They're shooting. The numbers are down now, only 57%. Louisiana Tech up slightly from the stats we showed you earlier. Holtzclaw, great move inside. Shamiqua Holtzclaw has 18 points in the first half.
Holtzclaw came from the weak side, top of the key, all the way down to the baseline, and nobody picked her up. It's like all the blue jerseys were looking at the ball.
I'd make an effort to find her. Jackson trying to take Jolly off the dribble, goes baseline. Jackson's got quite a game. She is a sweet-looking player, sophomore from Dallas, Texas, with 8 points.
And she certainly has some hops on her. She's one of the quickest dribblers and off the dribble that we've seen and gets off on her jumper very high.
Jolly with a set shot, 3, and like a knife in the heart.
Jolly doesn't have to jump very high. As long as you give her space, she'll knock those down.
Pat Summitt sees her club go up by 23 at the 3-minute mark of the first half. Louisiana Tech is facing a tremendous uphill battle here.
There's the double team.
Jackson knocked away. Here comes Jolly. Behind the back to Randall, and she's fouled. What a pass. Holy cow.
Just great court awareness as far as the Tennessee players know that somebody is going to be trailing them every time. There's 2 or 3 white jerseys every time down the floor. But it was the defensive trap that created this offense. We talked about the defensive pressure that the Lady Vols put on their opponents night in and night out, game in and game out, as far as how fast they're going to go.
What was also great about that She knew she was going to be cut off, so she went to the right of the lane to give whoever teammate was following her a space to go for the bucket. It was just tremendous. It has really been a show for Tennessee. Player of the Year, Shamiqua Holzbaugh, and the emotional leader of this team, their point guard, Kelly Jolly, are really putting it to Louisiana Tech.
And you have to have the desire of winning a national championship, and there's still a lot of time on the clock.
Well, thank you. All-American Tisha Panatiero, Mike.
All right, thanks, Nancy, and thank you, Tisha. Here is Jackson trying to get the ball down low to Burris again. Threw it too strong this time, and Tennessee hustling back down court. Jolly lost it. Oh, tremendous collision as Ketching slams into Jackson and may have caught a shoulder right in the chin.
I think Tamika Ketching in the last three games has taken a shot like that the last three games we've seen. Both players going after the basketball.
Oh.
And just gets nailed. But she's back up, which is Tamika Ketchings.
Well, it looked like forehead to forehead.
Might have a headache.
Right now, Louisiana Tech has a team headache. They're down by 24 with 2:12 to go. Going back to help out on the press, Wilson. Jolly knocks another one away. Stallworth trying to get something done on the wing. Got it under to Burris, and Burris scores again. Burris has 10 of the 29 points for La Tech. And Ketchings goes down hard ahead of the pack trying to run with Wilson.
Feet got tangled up in the air that time. I tell you, Tamika Ketchings should wear pads. Hip pads, knee pads, elbow pads.
The record for points and a half in the NCAA final game is 52. Louisiana Tech would have to hold Tennessee scoreless for almost 2 minutes not to have that record broken against them. Nice catch by Stallworth. Got it over to Maxwell for three. Burris with a foul. That won't go.
It's an unfortunate play because Maxwell finally had some time to take the shot. It was one of the first unrushed shots that Louisiana Tech had.
Ketchings, 15-footer. There's the record. 53 points in the first half. It's never been done before. And 15 for Ketchings.
And this season, Tennessee had 61 in the first half against Vanderbilt at the SEC tournament.
Well, I have to stretch it to get 61, but this is not bad for a title game. Maxwell tries another three. She's got great range and drains that one.
And Jackson is the only one that's really been hot on the outside for this Louisiana Tech team. Look at her just blow by. Randall just saw an opening, just blew by Stallworth. Stallworth didn't have a chance.
They just have so many weapons to come at you from so many different directions. 55-32. Stallworth is fouled by Jolly on the reach-in. It's number one on Jolly. Today's Chrysler student of the game, Tamisha Jackson from Louisiana Tech, on behalf of her Chrysler, proud to donate $1,000 to Louisiana Tech's General Scholarship Fund. Jackson holding for the last shot. The last thing they want to do is give Tennessee a chance to score another bucket before the horn. Here comes the
double
Stallworth. Look how far out they have to start the offense. Shot clock running down, and Stallworth has to throw up a prayer. What a great job by Tennessee. They came out with the trap before Louisiana Tech wanted to initiate its offense and forced them into a bad shot. Remarkable first half for the defending national champions, 55-32. Robin, that was some first half. Ann Myers, Nancy Lieberman Klein also with us. Tennessee out-rebounded Louisiana Tech 2-1 in the first half, 24-12. And that's what keyed the fast break. They got all the boards.
It really was. And we talked about rebounds in this game. We talked about defense transition on this game. And Louisiana Tech has not been able to do it, and Tennessee has on the boards, getting their break going. They've gotten it inside to Shamiqua Holzclaw. Then going inside is Tamika Catchings. And then also on the break situation, Samika with a little, oh, I thought it was going to be a spin move, a little jumper. But Samika Randall, and most championship teams, when they have the common thread of winning a national championship, it's been because of the magnitude of three scores like these three meets.
It is hard to imagine that Tennessee can play any better. They have been averaging with the three meets, combining for 42 points in the first half, 42 of the 55. But it's not like these are the only players they have. I mean, Jolly and Clement have certainly done their job. Jeter came off the bench, played great post defense for them.
And they have a wonderful bench. There's an article in the paper today about Braxton and Green, and well, you don't get any playing time. And both of those players were Tennessee Players of the Years in high school. And they said, we are just as much a part of this team as anybody else. And it takes players to play roles on this specific team, and Pat Summitt has made a lot of these players into great players.
Not a bad first half for Holzclaw. 18 points, 7 rebounds, 5 assists. Tennessee Tech starts the second half with a steal. Jackson on the run and score.
Holzclaw needs 14 points to break the scoring record that Bridget Gordon from Tennessee has here in the tournament, and needs 10 rebounds to break Cheryl Miller's record from SC.
Randall with a runner, she's short. Louisiana Tech coming out, trying to make something happen here in the second half.
Big key possessions for Louisiana Tech to start out like this.
Jackson with a huge three.
Great momentum for them.
55-37. It is a long road back, but not an impossible one.
And basically, you've got to believe, and you have nothing to lose right now. 20 minutes of it.
Catchings may be a little out of her range, although she is a good long-range shooter.
Oh, tough pass.
And bounced off of Tennessee out of bounds to Louisiana Tech.
And Pat Summitt not happy at all. She's yelling for Clement and Jeter to get right in there. She's talking about getting some rebounds and getting back on defense, but you can see the field goal percentage. A lot of those were layups off the break situation for Louisiana Tech, 62%. But the points in the paint, 36-16.
And the only points in the paint just about that Louisiana Tech got were when they were able to get the ball inside to Burris.
Jeter played most of that second half. The other thing is, too, LaShonda Stevens is not a player that gets up and down the floor as well as Teresa Jeter does.
Jackson on the inbounds pass. Louisiana Tech has scored 5 points to open the half. Rolls off the rim. Nice hustle. Maxwell with the save. And Maxwell will put it up and hit it. You got to hand it to Louisiana Tech. They have come out with fire in their eyes.
And the bench is right behind them.
And Pat Summitt wants to douse the flames as quickly as she can.
Well, we talked about her having a little bit more fun this year, but and the players said she is intense, and she'll let you know it.
Well, you remember as a player, when you had a big lead on somebody, it was so very difficult emotionally to stay with your game and do the technical things you're supposed to do.
We've talked so much about that this year, Mike, as far as this Tennessee team, because they get such large leads, and the intensity that they showed against Arkansas, they had a huge lead. How do you keep that up? But Pat Summitt instills it in them, and she, I bet, coming out of this timeout, they'll be on fire.
Clement will bring it up against Stallworth. Catching. She'll draw the foul from Burris. Checking its own Wilson, her first.
And she really has to get involved in the game. She was held scoreless, Mike, 0 for 4 from the floor, and Stallworth only had 2 points in that first half. But foul trouble for Burris with 2 fouls already, and Maxwell also has 2.
Catchings hits the first, she'll get another. 16 tonight for Catchings.
Coming into this game, Pat Summitt said she wanted her team to get to the line at least 30 times and the opponent 15 times. I'm sure Leon Barmer would like it the other way around.
Catchings drains them both. And here's another steal. Clement asked for the ball. Catchings again. holds court. The baseline couldn't hit the shot. The Lady Texters trying to run. They have a lot of ground to make up for. Stallworth, nice drive, but Ketching's got a piece of it, and then grabbed the rebound. Ahead to Clement. Clement gets the layup. So Tennessee responds, coming out of that timeout. And now it's Leon Barmore's turn. He's got a 20.
Well, he wanted a foul down here with Laquan Stallworth going in for the layup. He felt his kid was fouled and nothing was called. So he just wanted to make sure about the official knowing about it.
And certainly the officials have been basically invisible tonight, and which is the way you want officials.
It is, and both these coaches like to work the officials.
59-39, the lead at 20 with 17:52 to go in the national championship game.
And off those steals, that's where Tennessee in the first half was so effective, just getting somebody down. As soon as that ball's released, they're breaking somebody down, and Louisiana Tech has to get a body on them no matter when that ball goes up, so they don't get that break.
Stallworth, very good against the pressure, caught and trapped there. Jackson will call the play. Loops it low to Burris. Nice pass. Looks like some contact. No whistle. And then Jeter with another block. And Leon Barmore is after the officials again. Thought he had a good case that time. Clement to Holdsclaw. Boy, Burris. Gotta watch the elbows.
They'll call a technical on that swing in the elbows, especially if there's contact. That's right.
Three from Jackson comes up short.
And that's kind of a quick shot for Jackson. Maybe the offense wasn't really involved. You got to run that half-court game just a little bit longer. Get Burris involved. Get the ball inside.
Kelly Jolly, who set an assist record for the finals last year. Holdsclaw hits the long-range jumper. She has 20 just inside the three-point line. So after that quick burst by Louisiana Tech, that was a crucial timeout, I thought, by Pat Summitt. She got her kids back together again. Another steal. Here comes Ketchings, three on three, and she glides into the lane.
Just a great steal by Tamika Ketchings.
Clement did a great job on the baseline. Cut him off. It's a five-second violation.
Here's that pick and roll that they'd like to run, but the high pass, Burris had to go way high, and Ketchings was coming up and had her hand up, turned upwards rather than downwards, and that's why she was able to pop the ball loose and just makes a nice move down the middle.
Ketchings with the inbound, the lead back to 24.
That's a big hill to climb for Louisiana Tech. It started out hot, but can they continue that pace?
Nice save by Holzclaw. Baseline drive and a foul. And that looks like it's Burris. No, it's Wilson again. That's her second. Second team foul against Louisiana Tech. There have been very few fouls in this game. Randall will come back in for Ketchings. Tennessee trying to win its sixth national title under Pat Summitt, and its third straight. Jolly off the inbound. Just too many easy shots against Louisiana Tech's defense. Jackson, pull-up jumper. Boy, she has done everything she can. 18 points for Tamisha Jackson.
She's keeping him in the game right now. She's the only one hitting any shots.
Jeter had it knocked away, but Jolly recovers.
And if you're Tennessee, you're fine with that because you can have one player score double figures and hold everybody else down, and you're still going to win.
Holdsclaw. Somebody may have gotten a piece of that. They say no, and it's out of bounds to Louisiana Tech. 15-25 to go in the game. The lead, 24.
We talked about the defense. You can't put the ball that deep in the corner. That's where Tennessee wants you to be. You must try and see where the trap is coming from. Get the ball in the middle of the floor right there, then turn it up. Now you have the advantage, three on two. But look what happens to Tech. They go sideline to Randall's side. That's like trying to throw at Deion Sanders. The pressure, stats like this don't lie. The traps, deflections, steals, points off turnovers, those are things that do not allow you to get into your offense. And more than anything, if you don't have time, you're going to rush and take a bad shot, and that's what Louisiana Tech has done in the game. Mike and Annie?
Nancy, it's a tremendous statistic for Louisiana Tech. They had to use 15 seconds nine times tonight, and that really doesn't leave you a lot of time left and to run your offense.
No, it really doesn't. And not only rushing your shot with the time clock, but the defense, again, they cannot adapt to this quickness that Tennessee is throwing on them.
And there is really not very much of a counter that Leon Barmore can go to. If somebody's quicker than you are, they're quicker than you are.
And he has said all year long that depth on this bench is probably one of the weaknesses. He doesn't use it very much.
Maxwell, 15-footer over Jolly. And that was tipped. It's out of bounds to the Lady Texters.
Now, the last shot that Holzclaw looked, I think that was a little air ball right there that she shot before the timeout. This one, Maxwell definitely did get hit, or the ball got hit.
Louisiana Tech came out with a burst to start the half, but Tennessee has been able to answer and has a comfortable lead. Got it inside again to Burris, and whenever they've been able to do it, they've been quite successful with her shooting from short range. Burris has a dozen. Right back the other way. Randall fouled from behind by Burris.
Louisiana Tech not even turning to find out who's behind them. Randall sneaks on the baseline. Here on the other side, we're going to see Burris get the ball. But it's a tough pass inside. They have made some difficult passes inside to Elisa Burris, but she gets two on that, and then she comes back and gets called for the foul. But Randall snuck behind on the baseline, and Louisiana Tech, they've got to find a player and see where they are and see where the ball is.
Randall made all SEC second team this year as a freshman. She has 10 points tonight.
And we saw Leon Barmore talking to Kim Mulkey-Robertson, who was on the championship teams here at Louisiana Tech.
Holzclaw with an offensive rebound. She now has 22 points. Jackson hustles back the other way and fires the three. Another board for Holzclaw.
And the threes, they can either bring you right into the game or take you right out.
Glides right down the lane. Jeter did a great job of screening off the defense.
The one thing that I've seen teams playing Tennessee that have had problems with is stopping the ball. And here the ball has started way in the backcourt. Nobody picks Shamiqua Holzclaw up. They let her dribble the length of the floor, go all the way to the basket.
Holzclaw hits the free throw. 23 points for her. If you don't stop the basketball, if you don't force that first person to give it up, you're going to get killed.
Basic fundamentals, Mike, exactly. You've got to stop somebody. You don't pick them up at half court, pick them up at the top of the key.
And the intensity not waning at all for Tennessee.
Two-on-one situation.
Jackson, nice dish inside. Burris gets another bucket from point-blank range.
One of the few times Louisiana Tech has been able to break the press that easily.
Randall looking over to Pat Summitt, seeing what she wants, and they're going to spread the court.
There's a double pick.
Randall likes that spin move, but this time she traveled.
It's really a nice play set up. You go with the one pick at the top of the key, and then all of a sudden there's another pick. She went right by him, and she's so good at using that spin move that time. You said call for the travel.
Wilson goes baseline over Jeter. That's the first two for Amanda Wilson, who averages almost 19 a game. Checking the coach, she has four.
And Pat Summitt's telling her team, get back on defense. Oh, push off by Burris, she gets away with it.
And made a nice catch as well, and Burris puts it in. 16 for Burris.
Pat Summitt all over Samika Randall.
Not happy at all with the fact that Louisiana Tech is able to run a little bit here in the second half.
It was a good defensive play steal-wise for Louisiana Tech. Burris coming down the middle, and again, we talk about stopping the ball because the transition defense was not able to get down, and I think that Pat Summitt was upset that Jackson was not picked up high to kind of create diversion off that pass.
Still, the lead is 21 points with 13:33 to go. Louisiana Tech has hit 8 out of 15 shots in the second half, but it hasn't seemed to have made that much of a difference. Tennessee continues to hit on all cylinders. Clement. Behind the back pass, Jeter can't handle it. Tough to go to a post player with a bounce pass around the ankles.
Just more patience in the offense for Tennessee because Louisiana Tech doing a good job that time keeping the ball out of Holzclaw's hands. Barmar talked about not letting Holzclaw score in spurts. She had a layup, but she hasn't touched the ball in a while. There's that high pass. They need to go low.
Randall knocked it away from behind, and then Clement with a reach-in foul. That's going to be on Amanda Wilson, her fourth.
Tennessee defensively is picking up on that high post pick and roll play very nicely because the dribbler is picking up the ball. Before the game against North Carolina State, and you can see Leon Barmore a little upset with the call, against North Carolina State, the Lady Texters were keeping the dribble. And now they're picking it up against this trap, and they're going high over, which that high pass is giving time for the defense to step in.
Had several turnovers off of it, and Kelly Jolly hits a runner in the lane. Kelly Jolly with a dozen tonight, the junior from Sparta, Tennessee. Morris back the other way, and Jolly called for a blocking foul on the baseline.
Kelly Jolly just didn't give any room for Burris to come down. She didn't even turn. But there's that high pass, and they've got to get over there. And you see Kelly Jolly trying to come over and help, and Pat Summit not happy either with the call or the help. Knowing Pat, the help, or I should say the call.
That's right. Melchika Bowman, number 54, is in for the first time for Louisiana Tech.
But the Tennessee players are so good at, too. They keep their hands low, and that time Ketchings got caught. Because the offensive players, when they're turning, they're not always protecting the ball in what we call like the triple threat position, which is not used a lot anymore.
No. That'll be two against Ketchings. They call out a non-shooting foul, something that really upset the Louisiana Tech bench as well. The inbounds pass to Shepman goes right off her hand and out of bounds. 16 turnovers by the Lady Texters.
They've done a better job in the second half. Liam Barmore won the championship in 88. Trying to get his second.
Kelly Jolly with a miss. LaShonda Stevens back in the game. She is blocked by Bowman. Now keep in mind, this Louisiana Tech team is 31-3. They have won 16 straight games. They started the season ranked number 2 in the nation. They're number 4 in the last poll. And they are just getting crunched by this Tennessee machine. Ketchings.
Oh, nice call.
Pretty defensive play again by Bowman. Stallworth back the other way, missed the shot, knocked out of bounds, out to Louisiana Tech.
Kelly Jolly forcing the offensive player to do what they don't want to do. And it should be the offensive player forcing the defense, but a nice play by Kelly Jolly. Pat Summit wearing blue. She was looking pretty orange when she came in tonight.
Shepman picked up her dribble, now gets it to Stallworth. Stallworth swipes her hand at Randall. There's a little edge going on right now, and Shepman hits a three. And a foul underneath. Let's see.
It's going to be on Stevens. Stevens and Bowman, or Burris, were going at it.
Stevens picks up her second, so it was away from the ball. That means it's a non-shooting foul.
And a nice turnover for the Lady Texters.
The basket counts, and they get the ball back. 72-52. Good pass by Shepman, and then Burris couldn't hold it. But good, quick hands by Louisiana Tech inside. And they'll get the basket from Bowman. Jolly back the other way with a three.
She has been big time in this game.
Kelly Jolly with 15 points to lead back to 21. Stallworth got a good screen, and Bowman got the return pass, couldn't hit the shot.
That's a tough shot for the miss.
Holtzclaw's been very quiet lately. Kelly Jolly has not. 18 for Jolly. She's hit two straight threes and 7 out of 8 shots on the night.
Just keep backing her up.
If I'd hit 7 out of 8, I'd be yelling too. 78-54. Bowman outside trying to get it to Burris, and they throw it away.
Defensive rotation by Tennessee has been fabulous. Just confusing Louisiana Tech.
Kelly Jolly with a career-high 18 points. What a time to save your best for the national championship game. Holtzclaw has become very familiar with the national championship game, a double-double in her freshman year, an MVP performance last season. Tonight, she's working on another MVP performance. She has 24 points, 6 in the second half, 9 rebounds, and 6 assists. If that's not an MVP performance, there hasn't been one.
And a tremendous, consistent player, but it also shows you the ability to play big in big games when it counts.
And it's not like she's forcing her shots either. These come as part of Tennessee's normal offense. Jeter to inbound. Tennessee up by 24.
Talk about the versatility. Tamika Catchings bringing the ball down where all the guards go down and post up and get ready in the offense.
Catchings with a set shot. Randall with a rebound. Snatched it with one hand. What a future Randall and Catchings have. Tremendous players as freshmen.
Got someone just using the clock, spreading the floor out.
Holtzclaw, double team that she got in the lane and foul. Bowman will pick up the personal.
And Holtzclaw will have one in the air.
Yes, he will. Coming out early has not been a problem for the women's game as yet, but as the money increases, the visibility of the pro leagues increase, it's going to be a problem.
But especially on this Tennessee team, though, it is important when you come there, you play for Pat Summitt, you get a degree, and you graduate. And they talked about that. Holtzclaw's grandmother's very concerned about. They met Michael Jordan this year, and Michael Jordan told Holtzclaw and all the other players, stay in school. And I think it's a great message, and the women should learn from the men that you need to have an education to go and play ball anytime.
79-54, there is no letdown in the defensive intensity. And of course, Nancy Lieberman Klein, who will be the coach and general manager of the new Detroit franchise next year in the WNBA. Nancy, this is going to be a problem, I can only assume, for women's collegiate basketball when people start leaving early.
Well, there's so many changes happening right now in women's basketball, not obviously at the collegiate level with decisions by the kids, but also at the pro level, because we have the ability now to offer opportunity. And I think a lot of the players are seeing it, whether they say it or not. I mean, they're working towards that goal.
Which is too bad, because to me, it's a great opportunity to play at the college level. It's a great time of your life to be in school.
I agree with Annie on that. I think if you have a chance to stay in school.
Go ahead, Nance. Well, I think any lawyer worth his salt will tell you that this is an easy enough thing to break if somebody does want to come out. They did it with the men, and they'll certainly be able to do it with the women.
It'll happen, but it's unfortunate that the parents don't take a bigger step and get involved and get an education for these kids.
18 points tonight for Alisa Burris. Make it 19. 79-57, and Louisiana Tech has certainly played much better in the second half, but they simply can't get the margin down to a working one.
And Louisiana Tech has stayed in this man-to-man defense. It's what they play all year long. Liam Butler is known for his man-to-man defense, as Pat Summitt's teams are.
Holtzclaw goes baseline against Wilson.
What a nice move.
And knocked away. Jeter, good defensive job to force the loose ball, and Jolly picks it up.
Wilson saw a blue jersey down there, just couldn't get a handle on the ball and took her eye off of it.
Jolly guarded man-to-man by Jackson. Holtz call being much more aggressive offensively in the last couple of minutes in the stretch and threw that one away. Tennessee hitting one of those sloppy periods right now. Maxwell glides in and scores.
And it's a tempo, even though Pat Summers kind of like slowed the game down in this half-court game, it's slowed the offense a little bit and kind of taken the energy out, too.
I think it really has. Approaching the 8.5-minute mark, the lead is 20. Jolly, set shot, baseline. Randall, rebound. Partially blocked. Great defense by Bowman. Then stolen back by Ketching, stolen away, and stolen back yet another time by Stoller.
Wow.
Jackson for three.
Oh, is that nice?
Tamisha Jackson, who has made 53 three-pointers this year coming in, forces Pat Summitt to call a 20-second timeout. Jackson has 19 points in this game. And she is not happy with Shamiqua Holmes-Claw. And now Tennessee has changed its mind. They'll go with a full timeout as La Tech's back within 17. 79-62 Tennessee. And let's go back to that last sequence and see what Pat Summitt was upset with over Shamiqua Holmes-Claw.
Well, the ball is around. There is Shamiqua. Just kind of a little lazy dribble. And Stallworth was right there and then get back on the defensive end. The ball goes to the corner with a nice shot by Jackson, and it's nice to know that Pat Summitt does not play favorites. It's that tough love.
Shamiqua has heard it before, as yes. Have anybody who has played for a coach as demanding and as excellent as Pat Summitt. But that's her job. You know, you make a mistake out on the court, you're going to hear it.
And it shows you the personality of Shamiqua Holmes-Claw. She's sitting there and kind of laughs about it. And it shows you that as intense as Pat can get, when it's over, they're still buddies.
7:47 to go in the national championship game. Clement got it inside to Randall. She missed the shot. Tennessee Tech, as poorly as they played, hanging around. Stallworth got it inside, and they force a foul as Burris put it up.
That's what Louisiana Tech, mouthful, isn't it? That is what the Lady Texters are trying to do, is force the issue going inside and trying to get themselves to the free throw line. Burris has been there a few times in the second half now, but they've got to keep going inside and creating something at the foul line.
Burris, the second team Associated Press All-American, first team by the U.S. Basketball Writers.
And there were a lot of high expectations of Elisa Burris. They thought that she might be a Kodak All-American this year and really did not start out well. Had great numbers last year, had a super year, was all newcomer in the Sun Belt Conference, and just really started out slow, but she's played well for the end of the season.
She has missed two out of three field goals, or free throws, check it. John Madry, our statistician, just came up with an assist on the loose ball.
He saved you.
Yes, he did. Missed opportunity there. Those free throws could have kept the lead to 15 points. They haven't been that close since early in the first half. They are on an 8-0 run.
Tennessee, a one-on-one situation, just not running any plays right now in this half court.
Shot clock is down to 8. And it's up to Randall. Forced the shot up, did not get the roll. Nice defense by Stallworth.
Oh, great hustle.
Good hustle. Maxwell kept it alive. Louisiana Tech coming back the other way.
And Jackson got hit in the stomach.
Yes, she did. Jackson with 13 points, and she is hurt.
Well, Leon Barmore upset, just kind of sitting there saying, what happened to my kid? He said yesterday in practice, if you see Jackson coming down the court, he said, you are faster than a rocket. I've seen you run. You can outshoot a rocket. And she did that time. She came down the floor and just stopped and popped. She's had a marvelous game so far.
Catchings will go to the line. Louisiana Tech has cut it to 15 points with 6:48 left.
Tamika Catchings and Shanika Holzbaugh, the only two junior classes as a freshman and a junior as Kodak All-Americans. Everybody else was a senior, except maybe Kristen Fokel. It just depends on what she wants to do, whether stay in school or,
right.
or leave.
Wonderful volleyball player.
She'll graduate on time. She just has one more year eligibility of basketball.
Catching's also working on a double-double. Got nine of them this year.
A zone by Tennessee.
Trying to cut down that penetration that Stallworth has gotten the last couple of possessions.
And see what Louisiana Tech does against them, how they can get through it.
They got it inside to Wilson, and then Wilson's pass was too strong, saved, but to Tennessee.
Oh!
A lot of contact, no whistle.
Randall just bowled Stallworth over.
Didn't she ever.
And Pat Summit's looking for a block or a pass out. One of these, she's out talking to Randall about passing him back out, but Randall just runs Stallworth wide over.
Jolly to inbound, 22 on the shot clock. Holzbaugh back in the game, fired that one too strong, but Jeter put it in.
Jeter just going to the basket, hands up in the air, ball fell right in her hands.
One of the few times you'll see Holzbaugh off balance, fired the shot off the side of the basket support. 83-64.
This also stops the outside shooting. Louisiana Tech has got to try and spot somebody up, get some penetration into the zone.
Jackson over a screen will take the three.
Well, that's what Pat Summit wants, is shots like that, because the long rebound, the zone is going to block out and get the long rebound.
You notice Jackson does a great job of holding her follow through on these long range
shots.
Really
does.
Really helps her. 83-64, Tennessee just working on the clock. It's their biggest friend right now. Catchings with a left hand. 23 for Tamika Catchings. And every time Louisiana Tech shows a little burst, Tennessee comes right back. They've extended the lead to 21.
This move, look at how high Catchings is, and then all of a sudden she just dips right under the defense, but she is so adept of using her left hand because of her dad, Harvey Catchings, who is left-handed.
Got a timeout on the court. The lead is 21 for Tennessee. They're unprecedented. The word championship has become synonymous with their names. 5 for Summit, 10 for Wooden, but another constant, the great player that each coach, Lou Alcindor at UCLA, and Shamiqua Holzclaw could take over the game like none before and wrap their coach in the aura of a legend. John Wooden far surpassed the other legendary coaches in the men's game, and Pat Summit has done the same thing in the women's game. Tonight would be her 6th. You have to go back to the early days of women's basketball to find the other dominant coaches in this sport.
Kathy Rush and Margaret Wade. As a matter of fact, Louisiana Tech has won 3 national championships, but Leon Barmore was an assistant for 2 of those under Sonia Holt.
Sheffin is back into the game for the Lady Texters. Great interior defense again for Tennessee. Try to get it inside. And a foul as Catchings was hacked before she could get the shot up.
And that's a big play coming out of this timeout with about 5 minutes left. And for Louisiana Tech, every timeout's important coming out to try and take advantage of it.
Bowman committed the foul, her 2nd. This will be a 1-1 for Catchings. Missed it, but Jeter got it back and tipped it to Catchings. A fresh shot clock for Tennessee.
And Tennessee's spreading it out again. They'll use the clock. They're running things down.
Catchings will come out. She's got the 6'2 Bowman waiting for her at the free throw line. Tries to go by her, loses it to Shepman. Then knocked right back. Great recovery by Catchings.
Well, I talked to Harvey last night, and he was saying he had talked to Tamika after the Arkansas game. He goes, Dan, I just didn't play well. I was so frustrated. But she plays so hard, and when she makes mistakes, she comes back and does something special.
She had 13 points and 8 rebounds against Arkansas. Those are not great numbers for her. Holtzclaw with a rebound. It's a 2-on-2. Holtzclaw in double figures in rebound, and another double-double on the year. Time running out for the Lady Texters. 4:09 and counting.
They're the ones that have to be the aggressors. They've got to be aggressive on offense. They don't have much time to pass it around. They've got to look for good shots. And then on the other end, they've got to come up and be the aggressors on defense.
Shepman got a tough entry pass in there. Burris forces it up, doesn't get the bucket, but will draw the foul. She really worked hard on that possession to keep it alive. Jeter picks up her second.
Elisa Burris, the senior on this team at 6'3", starts for them and just really working hard underneath. She has run an awful lot, played hard in this game.
19 points, 10 rebounds, pretty good numbers in a championship game where the other team is dominating you.
She got her double-double, and Maxwell and Jackson have been hitting some shots, but Stallworth, a leader on this team that's been playing so well coming into this game, has just gone ice cold, 0-for-6, and struggled, only 2 points in this game.
It looked like in the first half, Annie, they wanted Stallworth on the wing and have Jackson act as the point guard most of the time. And it's a situation that didn't work out for them, especially after the semifinal where they saw Stallworth so great at the point.
That's right. Stallworth almost looked shell-shocked defensively when Tennessee came out on her and just really did not get into the flow of the game.
85-64. Tennessee in complete command tonight. And Catching's called for travel. Priya Gilmore will come back in. And that is the predominant emotion if you're a Louisiana Tech player or fan. They were stunned early by Tennessee, who threw that full court press at them and hurt them badly with turnovers and easy buckets.
Passes on those traps that they have to do is go low or in between, just step in between the trap when they jump up in the air.
Here's a foul by Jackson trying to apply some pressure. Tuesday, ESPN has complete. Charlie hits the free throw. Kelly Jolly with 19 points. Jolly with a career-high 20. And the lead is back to 21 points. And a 20-second timeout called by Louisiana Tech. And Kelly Jolly just beside herself with joy. She has had a sensational final game. And remember last year, Annie, when she was so outstanding, 20 assists in 2 games, set a title record with 11 assists.
She really was spectacular. Pat Summitt has relied on her. A lot of people look at, well, maybe she doesn't have the speed, maybe she's not as fast, but Pat Summitt has said Randall's an emotional leader, but you see Kelly Jolly in there being just as emotional, and she knows that she is a leader out there because she thinks like Pat.
Jolly with that career high. She's hit 4 threes. Louisiana Tech shooting 56% in the second half. But the way Tennessee has played, they might have needed to shoot 75. And Jackson with 21 points and 5 assists.
Tennessee looking for that trap.
Shepman tries a 3, can't hit it.
You know, this Tennessee team, Pat Summitt, talks about the quality of the players and the ability of these players, but she also gives credit to her bench, which she has Mickey DeMoss, Holly Warlick, and Al Brown. Mickey DeMoss and Holly Warlick have been with them for 13 years. As a matter of fact, Mickey DeMoss was on the very first 3 Louisiana Tech teams as a guard. There she is in the brown right there, and averaged 17 points her first year at Louisiana Tech. And Holly Warlick was an All-American at Tennessee. And Al Brown, they are the defensive minds, and to change and to put pressure and to make Pat say, look, this team can put pressure on for 42 minutes. Let's do it.
2:39 to go. Jolly backdoor cut, had it blocked. Jackson pushing it. Line drive jumper won't go for her. Shepman, nice job to keep it alive, but it's out of bounds to Tennessee.
Louisiana Tech trying to get quick shots now.
Right there, spot.
Nobody likes to lose, particularly a guy like Leon Barmore, but at least this is going to be a little easier for him to take, I think, than the 94 game when North Carolina beat them at the buzzer. He said it was the most hurtful experience he had had in his coaching career. It took him a long time to get over it. And Catchings is clobbered as she goes inside. Gilmore just leveled her. Leon Barmore, as you said, had been an assistant coach with this club when they won a national championship, won one of his own in 88. Great career record in the tournament, and 8 Final Fours to his credit.
And you really have to give credit to him as far, and also his coaching staff as far as the recruiting. Louisiana Tech is not, quote, a major Division I program. And he said to us yesterday, he said, you know, we're really lucky that we haven't fallen by the wayside like the Immaculatas and the Delta States. And it shows you how competitive this program is on the national level.
Well, he deserves the credit for this program not falling by the wayside. You have to go out and recruit kids for your program. And Kelly Jolly comes out to a standing ovation as Pat Summitt is going to get some of her bench players in there. But I always felt that if you're going to lose a ball game, the ones that gnawed at you forever were the ones you lost at the buzzer. It's the games where you were never really in it. They don't hurt quite as much.
It's a game that he won't talk about. And so that's history, and we're here now. And he's got a wonderful team that's coming back next year, except for Burris.
Lady Texter's still in there battling. Maxwell is really tough. At 5'9", she can really get up. Plummet is in to run the club now with 1:41 to go in the ballgame. Plummet goes down. Jackson, nice steal.
Randall coming from behind.
And nobody helped her. Loose ball, they pick it up and score.
What you call two sprinters going down.
Teammates have to help you if there's a defender coming from behind. She had two out there and nobody yelled.
They were going too fast.
Yeah, they were. Maybe faster than the speed of sound. Jackson hits another bucket. She's had quite a ball game. But she hasn't gotten a lot of help. Burris played well. Nice job by Catchings to keep the dribble alive. Shot clock at 5. Holds call. With a 3. Another rebound to Maxwell. Under a minute to go. Jackson.
Good hustle.
Still fighting. Got it back. Clement. Great effort by Clement. And then Catchings is fouled by Shep. The Tennessee fans come to their feet all around the Kemper Arena. They have seen a marvelous performance by their kids tonight. A team that had averaged won by an average of 30 points a game this year. And they're up by 19 right now in a national championship game. Holds claw. Hugging Clement at midcourt as Pat Summitt gets ready to clear the bench.
Special team this has been all year. People have wondered whether they could do it. What a great feeling.
And Leon Barmore is going to get Shepman and also Burris out of the ball game. And Grandma is just loving it.
Well, Pat has put her lone senior in, Lori Milligan, and she is the only player in NCAA history, men or women, to play in four national championship games.
Isn't that terrific? Milligan, the senior, and Shamiqua Holdsclaw, Nike player of the game. 25 points, 10 boards, her normal double-double, and she hit nearly 50% from the floor, 6 assists as well.
And Kyra Elzey, who had an ACL tear, is in the game in February. They've got her in there 3 weeks.
and she's got a big smile on her face. Kyra Elzy in there, Brene Laxton, Misty Green, Laura Milligan, and Nia Butts also on the court. Knocked out of bounds, 18.1, and it's at the Louisiana Tech.
And Leon Barmore putting the other senior, Katie Cochran, in, who doesn't get a lot of playing time, but a chance to play in the national championship team, and sadness on the Louisiana Tech bench, but they've got to be proud of being here because they're one of two teams that made it.
Jackson launches another one from downtown. Jackson with a brilliant game, 26 points. Elzy tried to put the shot up and couldn't. Nia Butts got the follow. Team ever to go 39-0, and they have won their third straight national championship, unprecedented in the NCAA. You have to go back to the AIAW to find two teams who had won three in a row. Just a sensational performance by the Tennessee Volunteers. They came out and did it early with their defense. .93-75. It was just too much from the three Meeks. Holzclaw with 25. Ketchings with 27. Randall with 10. And it's time to pass out those national championship t-shirts. Holzclaw being embraced by her coach, Pat Summitt, who was yelling at her earlier, but that's what coaches do. And Pat Summitt, certainly a remarkable record, having won a national championship now in 87, 89, 91, 96, 97, and 98. She will not lose one of her premier players off this ball club. Holzclaw will be back as a senior. And just what a marvelous performance, what a great feeling it has to be for Pat Summitt to go 39-0. It's almost mind-boggling. Let's go to Ann Myers with Pat Summitt.
Pat, congratulations. Number three in a row, six national championships, 39-0. Just your thoughts right now.
Annie, I am so happy for this basketball team and so appreciative of their effort and the effort of our staff. And our fans have been tremendous. It's just a great victory for the University of Tennessee. But the people I think the most about right now are the players. They were just awesome tonight. They were ready to play.
You got a little intense sometimes. They started to make a comeback on you a little bit, a little run, but you got, your defense was tremendous.
Well, you know, I decided tonight's my last time to coach for a while. I'm not going to hold back. So, yes, I showed a lot of emotion, but the team responded. So, really proud of this young lady.
Shamiqua, talk a little bit about coming into this game. What's it, what it's all meant to you?
First, I have to give my shout-out to all the homies back in Astoria and the QB. What's up, what's up? Well, this game is really important because I want to keep my streak going with championships. And plus, this team has worked so hard, and we want to go out there and win a championship for this team. Forget about all the history.
Talk about the two key things for you guys all year long, rebounding and defense coming into this game.
Yes, and tonight, you know, we went out there. Everybody won the KK Award. That's our defense award. We really hit the boards, and we were just there for transition defense. We played pretty good well tonight.
And you gave it a chance for everybody to come in and play.
Yes, and everyone played awesome tonight, and that's what it's about, team.
Seven championships for you in a row, going for number eight?
Yes, I'm going to be working on that, working hard over the summer.
Congratulations.
Thank you, Annie.
Good job. Thanks. Mike, back to you.
Annie, that is a remarkable record with seven consecutive championship teams that she has been a part of, and not just a part of, a leader on. And here's what she did at Christ the King High School. As a freshman, held below a double-double the other 3 years she was able to do that. And then at Tennessee, 16-14 as a freshman, 24-7 as a sophomore, and remarkable numbers again tonight to win another title. 25 points and 10 boards. Let's check in with Nancy Lieberman Klein. Nancy.
Well, thanks, Mike. I have a very happy Kelly Jolly. It seems that you saved the best for last. Last year, a championship game against Old Dominion, 5 points, 11 assists, career high, 20 points tonight. What's up?
Pat said before the game for me to go out and be aggressive, and you know, it's hard to guard my other players, and I just got some open looks and was able to knock them down.
Well, you not only got open looks, but you were just setting them up from three long range. Now, I know a lot of attention goes to Shamiqua Holtzclaw and a lot of the Fab Four, but you being that stabilizing force on the team, you've been there all along.
Well, it's my role. You know, I've done that all season, and you know, as a point guard, I have to be the leader on the floor. I know I've got some great players surrounding me. It's fun to pass them the ball, and you know, they just make me better as well.
Now, I know you're trying to share some of that experience with that other freshman point guard, Kristen Clement. Tell me about the relationship quickly.
We have a great relationship. You know, we understand that we're going in for each other, and we can talk about the game as it's going on. It's just a really nice relationship.
Well, Kelly, thank you. Congratulations. Robin?
All right, Nance, thank you very much. And to borrow a phrase from Shamiqua, I'm just hanging out with my homies here. And Rebecca, Pat Summitt said her players came ready to play, and Mimi, she came ready to coach tonight.
And those players were ready to play. They jumped all over the way.
Has captured its third straight national championship. Wanted to ask Ann Myers and Nancy Lieberman-Klein a question. What memory will you take away from this game do you think that will stick with you for a long time?
Well, the fact that not only did Tennessee have a lot of pressure coming into the game to win a third title, but they had fun. They enjoyed the trip, and a lot of people don't do that.
How about you, Annie?
I kind of agree. I think the intensity level that they came out, putting the pressure defense, and even in the rebounding, they were happy out there. Even when Pat was all over them, Shamiqua Holtzclaw smiling, they were just having a good time, and they felt that they were the best team out there, and they were going to come out and show everybody.
Oh, with three national championships in a row, they certainly have a past in women's college basketball. With all the talent they have and coming back, they have quite a future in women's college basketball. Quite an experience for us to be here in Kansas City and just watch Tennessee, what they do so best. Back to you, Robin.
All right, Mike, Annie, and Nancy, thank you very much. It has been an awesome ride yet again, Mean.
It absolutely has, and the memory that I'll have from the tournament in general, Robin, is the teams like Notre Dame once again in Arkansas. They are the poster teams for all the mid-majors out there who believe that it can happen. Plus, think about it, of the Sweet 16 teams, seven of them had three or more underclassmen in their starting lineups. Don't think that the next season belongs to Tennessee. Oh, no, 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 no. There's going to be lots of challenges, and it's going to be, we're going to go from this level here with the balance up to here next year. It's going to be great.
And this was just a fun season to be involved with women's college basketball. Everywhere you go, the excitement of this perfect team got everyone involved. People wanted to talk about Tennessee. They wanted to talk about this young kid, Shamiqua Holtzclaw. People are talking about women's basketball, women's college basketball. It's just reached a new level of excitement.
It has reached a new level of excitement. You think that Mimi will cry again when we go out there this year?
You had to say that, didn't you? Forget it. I'm not crying. Not shedding a tear.
It has been an absolute joy to bring you once again this NCAA Women's Tournament. This year was filled with surprises, upsets, passion, and a lot of emotion. As we leave you tonight, we want to share with you some lasting memories of March Madness.
It's shining over everyone. So give up because you've already won. You can live forever, but you'll take it one day at a time. Can you feel it? It's burning like a silver flame. It's all matter where you've been or your name. Separate yourself from all of your pain.
Tonight with the Tennessee Lady Vols winning their third consecutive NCAA title. For our entire ESPN crew, which is simply the best there is, including my two sidekicks, Mimi and Rebecca, who made the madness a little saner for me, I'm Robin Roberts. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. Good night, everyone. SportsCenter is next.
Be alert.